up, TTC? I wasn't going to even do a victory lap for this, you know, but in lieu of how the whole hate week went, you know, you had these motherfucking arrogant Giants fans feeling like they don't have to participate, you know. We started off with NY Gay Pride, you know. Be the first one that started off talking about, you know, I'm not going to address any Saints fans except in the grave. You understand? Then you have this other motherfucking guy, video maker, talking about, I'm not worried about this game and we going to win and all that shit. And a few motherfuckers that did do videos and shit, they did videos the day before the game or the day of the game and shit, like cop pissing. Punk ass. The New York Giant fans are the biggest fucking pussies in the TPC. Yeah, there go, I said it. You motherfuckers are the biggest pussies in the TTC. Y'all the typical hoes, and you should be on every motherfucking track that they got up there in New York. Period. You didn't fucking participate because you know your team was gonna lose, like they have done all of the previous times that they played against the Saints. You got blowed the fuck out again. You motherfuckers are whack. You understand? Like, listen to this motherfucker here, right? Let's listen to him. This motherfucker here got more reasons and shit than Erwin and Fight.
I don't think we played bad at all. Defensively is a different story. We didn't play very good defensively tonight. But at the same time, I'm not surprised because we're injured. So, you know, people are going to say, well, that's an excuse. Well, it's the truth. So, you know, I'm really disappointed in all these experts where, you know, they just blow Drew Brees and the Saints offense and whatnot. And, you know, we had third stringers out there playing linebacker tonight. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, what do they expect? You know, the middle of the field's wide open.
So. This motherfucker here talking about they lost the game because they injured. They were injured. You understand? So he offering that shit as a bullshit fucking excuse. When in week two, they played against the St. Louis Rams. And the St. Louis Rams' best player didn't play. Steven Jackson was injured. So I guess that should take away from, you know, their victory and shit. That's the same game that the motherfuckers started faking injuries and shit. Okay, in week 8, they played against the Miami Dolphins, whose starting quarterback, Chad Henne, went out for the season, I think, in week 3, if I'm not mistaken. So they was injured. You understand? And then they beat New England, you know, and he was all happy, you know, when they beat New England.
New England, we beat y'all sorry asses again.
New England have they motherfucking, you know, backfield and shit. They so injured till they got Edelman, a wide receiver, coming in playing cornerback and safety. So skip me with that bullshit that you talk. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, and let me ask you this, right? When you win games, do you also offer that excuse that you're injured? I mean, you know, do you say, okay, we injured? Does injuries play a part when you win? Now let's listen to this dumbass shit he has to say.
So, you know, I'm not giving any props to these fans. I mean, the majority of the Saints fans that I know in here are Joe. Gravy's a joke. He's a bandwagon fan. I mean, just watch his college football videos. You got a bandwagon fan right there. SaintsUptown or whatever his fucking name is. That's a joke. And Pet My Cat or whatever that fucker joke. Another classic bandwagon fan, so.
A joke? Motherfucker, you talking about who's a joke? You a fucking joke. First of all, you think you Ric Flair. You come on this motherfucker and you think you the nature boy Ric Flair, which is a joke. I think you from fucking Tennessee someplace, yet you a damn Giants fan. What's a joke is the fact that they kicked your ass out of the BBC. Because you are a motherfucking joke. They didn't want your southern country ass, you know, affiliated with their East Coast organization, their BBC. So, let's not talk about who the fuck is a joke. You the biggest joke, you know, filming your cat and shit. Kind of reminds me of somebody else I know. Let's not get into who's a fucking joke and who's not. Because you the biggest fucking joke on here. And everyone knows it. Except you. And so that means that the joke's on you. And you talking about getting injured and all that shit. But I bet you if the Giants were the one cop pissed, you would have been on this motherfucking shit taking more victory laps and shit than Kyle Busch. Jimmy Johnson and Dale Earnhardt Jr. wouldn't have had shit on you taking victory laps. So, get the fuck out of here with that bullshit that you're talking. So let me get on to something else too, right? I noticed how you punk-ass Atlanta Falcons fans too. How you coming on here and you're cheering for other teams to beat us. When you had your chance in that piece of shit Georgia Dome, remember? Fourth and inches at your own 29? Do you remember that? But now you're cheerleading for everybody. You understand? G-Simple 87 and K-Boy. Live in HL. You're gonna lose to the Giants. You're gonna lose to the Giants. I mean, you motherfuckers look stupid. And the same shit that we did them, we gonna do the same shit to you motherfuckers. Okay? When you bring y'all ass and shit to the motherfucking terror dome. And one more thing too I gotta say before I leave, right? You Bama fans, you understand? What makes you think that you guys deserve a shot at LSU again? We beat you raggedy motherfuckers at home, okay? And let's just think hypothetically speaking. If y'all beat LSU, right, would y'all deserve the motherfucking title? Y'all had a shot at the chance. You fucking lost. So deal with it, okay? And I had this other stupid-ass Bama fan talking about, y'all don't want to see a well-rested Bama team. Well, we'll be well-rested, too, even after we play the SEC game. Because then the championship game is not for another couple of weeks. Just like I told you before, when you was commenting back on informing me on Gravy's video, you's a stupid Bama-hick motherfucker. You understand? And I do notice, too, how certain Atlanta Falcon fans and Bama fans never crowed up after LSU beat them and the Saints. That's okay though, you understand? That's all right, you understand? If you're gonna be a bitch, we gonna treat you like a bitch. And that's all I really have to say for right now. Fuck the Falcons. Fuck the Giants. And fuck Bama. Who that, baby?